Wave your hand,
from your one number one. For me ready for the competition. Woman and man, wave your hand. Every man, every bitch, every fan, every deal, every wicked, every storm. For the art and soul and passion, and the culture, Caribbean blood. When people come out of nation, the team in a unification. When they get down from this, everyone stand and they lean in a unification.
It's how we play.
Antigua boasts of 365 beaches, one for each day of the year. It's the ideal place to relax, the sea, sand, and sun providing the perfect setting. Whether you choose Fort James, Deep Bay, or Galley Bay, you're sure to have a ball. Antiguans can also expect to have a ball when the island stages three Limacol Caribbean Premier League matches in the middle of August. Antigua is our next stop for another edition of the Limacol CPL Weekly as we greet you from St. John's.
Welcome to Antigua, one of the most beautiful islands in the Eastern Caribbean and one that will feature prominently in this year's Caribbean Premier League T20 tournament.
On today's program, we'll chat with Antigua's most successful test fast bowler who finds himself in a new role for the Limacol CPL. We'll also hear from Antigua's newly adopted son. We'll meet the man who drives the party at cricket matches here in Antigua. We'll also catch up with a youngster who recently came out of a self-imposed exile to suit up for his country, and we'll be watching the Limacol CPL very carefully. Don't go too far. Another riveting program is seconds away.
It's how we play.
Another 2020 cricket news, CPL T20 singers and musicians are set to arrive any day now.
It's how we play.
The Limacol Caribbean Premier League will be staged from July 30th to August 24th. The name of the Antigua franchise is the Antigua Hawksbills. Antigua is the largest of the English-speaking Leeward Islands at 108 square miles. With a cruise ship dock, lots of restaurants and boutique stores offering world-class brands, St. John's is a lively hub for shopping and dining. The coast of Antigua are ideal for yacht cruising and racing, and Antigua Sailing Week is a popular event on the annual sporting calendar. For an island that only had its first test cricketer in 1974, and staged its first international match in 1981, Antigua also has a rich cricket history. Among its 80,000 population, Antigua can lay claim to four of the finest cricketers to have come from this region: Sir Viv Richards, Andy Roberts, Curtly Ambrose, and Richie Richardson. It has also played host to a number of historic feats. Richards, widely acclaimed as the Master Blaster, enjoyed the distinction of blasting Test cricket's fastest Test century right here in Antigua. And twice in the space of 10 years, Brian Lara set the world record for the highest Test score on Antigua soil.
10 years ago, he set it, and he's done it again at the very ground.
Cricket in Antigua is not just about what happens in the middle. The electrifying atmosphere beyond the boundary is one of its trademarks. The inaugural Limacol Caribbean Premier League is certain to create another spectacle.
While I'm outside the ARG, I'm with Joanne. She's one of the biggest cricket fans in Antigua. She does not miss a game of cricket when it comes here. Joanna, are you looking forward to this Caribbean Premier League?
Yes, I am, definitely.
What makes you so excited about T20 cricket?
Well, I've always loved cricket, and it's I don't even know really how to explain it, but I love to see Caribbean sports. I love Caribbean sports, so it's always exciting for me to go out and see the support that everyone brings and the energy.
Kirtley Ambrose needs no introduction. For the record though, let's remind you that he's second on the list of highest wicket takers in Test cricket among West Indians. In a glittering career between 1988 and 2000, he took 405 wickets in 98 tests at an outstanding average of 20.99 apiece.
Ball in! That is wonderfully bowled by Kirtley Ambrose, the classic Yorker. The fourth wicket for the West Indies, three of those for Ambrose for West Indies.
In his early days, his Yorkers were deadly. Throughout, his line and length were impeccable. These days, he juggles things around a little bit as a bass guitarist in the band Spirited. As a radio and television cricket commentator for various networks and stations, and as a cricket coach of different teams. For the inaugural Limacol CPL, he will be working with the Guyana franchise, a role that will bring him under the microscope. Let's get his insights on a few things on and off the field.
Well, we're at the beautiful Cedar Valley Golf Course here in St. John's, Antigua, and I had to come here to find none other than Mr. Kirtley Ambrose, not doing too well on the, I think it was the second or third hole. I'm not quite sure because he's not sunk anything so far. Ambi, good to see you. All relaxed here in your home, Antigua, but you're going to be moving to Ghana, not permanently, but for the CPL. How do you feel about coaching Ghana or being part of the coaching setup with Roger Harper in the CPL?
Well, I'm looking forward to it. I've had a stint for more than a year with CCC, so I wouldn't say I'm really new to coaching. And that experience I've gained so far will, you know, work in good stead for me going into Guyana.
How are you looking forward generally to this T20 competition? There have been many T20 competitions before, but this promises to be the mother of all competitions.
I think it's necessary for us in the Caribbean. We need something to inject some life in cricket in the Caribbean and to generate some more interest. And I think that this T20, the CPL T20 that's coming up, will do just that. I'm looking forward to it, and I'm quite sure lots of people are looking forward to it.
When you look at the fact that the CPL T20 comes at a time where there's going to be Carnival in Antigua, Crophove in Barbados, do you think that it would give a nice gel and a mix for people who want to enjoy the best of both worlds?
It certainly will. Because lots of people are coming for Carnival, as I mentioned, a couple of in Barbados here in Antigua, July, August. So I believe the turnout will be great. Everyone taking some cricket during the daytime, early evening, and then go to party late at night. So I think this time of the year is a great time to have the T20.
Ladies and gentlemen, the winners of the ICC 2020 West Indies.
What has made West Indians so successful at T20 cricket?
I believe the guys enjoy T20 a lot more than they do 50 overs or Test cricket. And I could be wrong, but judging from what I've seen, they seem to be really focused when they play T20. Of course, you don't have any margin for error. One bad over could cost you, or one good over could win your game. So they have got to be in a piece that keeps on ball one. And they do play T20 a lot better. I'm just hoping that they can transform this good form from T20 into 50 overs and Test cricket.
And Guyana, looking forward to traveling to Guyana?
Well, I'm a professional, and wherever I have to go to do any coaching, it can only enhance the cricketers, because I want to believe I've learned a lot over the years playing cricket, especially as a fast bowler. I believe I know a thing or two about fast bowling, and as long as what I'm going to share can enhance West Indies cricket and make it better, well, I'm happy to do so.
So Kirtley Ambrose, happy to not just to represent Ghana in terms of his assistant coaching, but also looking forward to the Caribbean Premier League. I'm going to let him get back on the golf course because he's not doing too well on the ninth hole.
When we come back, we'll talk to an adopted son of Antigua.
It's how we play.
It's
how we play.
Marlon Samuels is one of six franchise players in the tournament. It's no surprise. Samuels was one of the heroes behind West Indies' victory in the ICC World 2020 last year. He's been in splendid form with the bat over the past year, leading to him being named one of Wisden's five cricketers of the year. He is sought after by the majority of the 2020 leagues around the world, having turned out for the Pune Warriors in the Indian Premier League, the Melbourne Renegades in the Australian Big Bash, and the Toronto Rajasthan in the Bangladesh Premier League. Let's get ready to add a new team. Samuels won't be lining up for his native Jamaica in the Limacol CPL. Instead, he'll suit up for the Antigua Hawksbills.
I think it's wonderful because you get to play for a different island and represent, but playing for West Indies, you play for the entire region, you know. So I'm representing Antigua, and I'll just go there and represent Antigua to the best of my ability. A lot of secret behind it, but I could pinpoint a few things, and the main thing is, as you could see, standing here, a lot of dogs around me, you know. Family, that's priceless, you know. The time that I spend with my family and the time that I have to balance my entire life just to work out, training, and still find time to drop the kids to school hard in the mornings because it's very early. But I enjoy doing these things, so I mean, I see myself after cricket. Kids would be much older, but I could go to graduation, all these things. So I jot down a lot of things that I would like to see happen. So it's just, I'm just a man with a plan. To be honest, early in my career, life, been hit with many obstacles, but most of them take a little while for me to recover from them. But what I've learned how to go about them. So a lot of obstacles makes me more experienced with dealing with them. And I have grown because I've sit down and think about, if I have a problem, I think about the problem with at least and come up with at least 5 to 6 solutions. So I'm a thinking person at the moment. I never used to think back then. I used to just act. So now I think before I act. So I mean, all of that contribute for me to be the mature person that I am right now. And it's just spilling and flowing over into my game. Well, to me, apart from being the number one cricketer in the world, that's what I'm striving for. But the Bible is a million times better than anything that a cricketer could ever want. I could tell you a story going way back for my first coach, is Roy McLean. He's should be about 90 right now. He's the one that gave him my technique and teach me everything about the game. And what he said to me is that as a cricketer, you can achieve a lot of things. But being in the cricket Bible is the ultimate, and the ultimate, I've achieved it, and he's a very happy man today. It's wonderful. It's come at a perfect time when we're now world champion in T20. You know, we're still enjoying the moment. The team, when you look at the team right now, with it is very good for West Indies cricket because players going around the world and playing cricket and getting more experience and bringing all that back into a West Indies team. So you'll definitely see a stronger West Indies team in the future. For Mr. Khan to come now and decide that he wants to push cricket and find more talent. So it couldn't come at a better time now. So as a West Indian, I'm very proud.
Many cricket fans who live outside Antigua might not know this, but when the Antigua Recreation Ground used to stage Test cricket, there were days when there were more fans in the double-decker stand after a day's play was completed than there were during the day's action. Hundreds of people used to turn up for the informal post-match party that went on through the night. The man responsible for drawing the crowd and bringing the party then and now is DJ Chicky. As he cued the tracks, Bird in Flames, Short Shirt, Michelle Montano, Super Blue, the list goes on. The place was transformed from cricket to carnival. For several years, Chicky was the life of the ARG. He now does his thing at the Sir Viv Richards Stadium. You've heard him on the Wheels of Steel. Let's get to know him a little better.
If you're really into music and you know music, you know the songs, the current songs, the past songs, you know, and you're really on the ball, talking cricket, you're on the ball, songs just come naturally to you. For instance, like one time it was raining and right after the rain, I played a song, I Can See Clearly Now, right? And people just went crazy. So you do things like that. You play songs like Burning Friends had a song, Batu, songs that have meaning to do with the cricket. It's T20 cricket, you know. That's the way to go. That's what bringing out the crowds. It's more excitement, and you know, I think that test cricket will always be there, but the vibe, and that's what people are looking for, you know, that quick vibe. And the T20 is going to be, the C-T20 is going to be just like the IPL, you know. We are the ones who taught them, you know. So I think it's going to be a great thing.
We've got much more on the Limacol CPL Weekly when we come back. It's how we play.
We have come to play.
Yo, we here too.
We have come to play.
We've come to play.
Hey, don't forget about us, mate.
Yeah.
You know why we're here.
We always play.
That's how we play.
You playing? You better be. Check CPLT20.com and join the party.
It's how we play.
You could call it the second coming of Sylvester Joseph. In 2008, he quit all forms of regional cricket before the age of 30. It was a surprise to many. Equally surprising is his decision to come out of retirement this year. He returned to captain the Leeward Islands for the 2013 regional season and has offered himself up for draft selection of the inaugural Limacol CPL. Whether playing or not, Sylvester Joseph is still happy to be a part.
Antiguans, they're still very frenetic about their cricket. You expect that to change, or that will continue for the T20 tournament?
I think it's gonna change for the better. You know, people are yearning for this competition to get started, to kick off. You know, we've been watching it all over the world, in the different continents, all the territories, they have their own. But now that we have in our own in the Caribbean, I think the Caribbean people will be delighted. Well, I think that our players, you know, prove that they are quality in the different competition that they enter into, they dominate. So for us now, as the local players, in terms of the regional players, to mingle with these guys and play with some of the international legends as well, it should be good for West Indies cricket.
Growing up, Sylvester, who were some of your favourite cricketers and why?
Well, I really love Sir Vivian Richards. Ambrose was my favourite bowler. I played with him and, you know, played against him, and I don't... From all the bowlers that I have seen and played against, I think he's the best. You know, it's a privilege for me. The first prize that I got, you know, trophy, he was the one that gave it to me. I don't think that he remembers it, but I never got it. But I started training with the likes of Ridley Jacob and Dave Joseph and so forth. So these are the guys that I really was looking forward to playing with, and you know, and really propelling my career, and they really helped me.
What do you think is making 2020 cricket so exciting around the world, and of course right here in the West Indies?
I think it's the way of the world is going at the moment. You know, everything is in a short span. People like to get in and get out and get be entertained, you know. And also you're gonna have some seriousness in the game, you have some quality also in the game, you know, situation in the game where you have to really use your brain a lot. You have to check the situation and so forth in the game, even though it's a shorter version. If you watch the IPL, you watch the different competitions, 2020 competition, you see some period in the game that, you know, you have to really show your maturity, show that you are inclined with what is happening. So it's really entertaining, and also, you know, it's a positive light for every aspiring cricketer as well.
Before we go, we've just got enough time to show you the matches in the inaugural Limacol CPL.
We have your hand, from your one number one. From your ready for the competition. Yeah. You don't take intimidation. Yeah. Ready, woman and man. We have no hand. Yeah.
This is how we play the game.
This is how we play. Yeah, yeah,
yeah. And we gon' represent and show them who we stand for. Let's turn it up and light the flame.
Like a flame.
If you're not here to give it all, then what you here for?
So
that's it for this week's program. See you again next week. I'm Barry Wilkinson.
It's how we play.
Every band, every bat, every pitch, every pond, every deal, every wicket, every stone. And the heart and soul and passion, and the culture, Caribbean blood.
It's how we play.
We come out all nation, be the team in a unification. When the stadium run beach at the grandstand, and the meaning of beautification.
It's how we play.